Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvenni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the solution and discussion on the gate question paper in Mechanical Engineering subject. And this is lecture number 37. We are continuing with the convection heat transfer questions. So in the earlier lecture also, we solved questions from the convection heat transfer. So here we continue. And the question from 2005 question paper, an uninsulated air conditioning duct of rectangular cross section of 1 meter by 0.5 meter carrying air at 20 degree Celsius with a velocity of 10 meters per second is exposed to an ambient condition 30 degree Celsius. Neglect the effect of the duct construction material for air in the range of 20 to 30 degree Celsius. The data are given below, the properties of air. Thermal conductivity 0.025 watts per meter Kelvin, viscosity 18 micropascal second, Prandtl number 0.73, density is 1.2 kilogram per meter cube. The laminar flow Nusselt number is 3.4 for constant wall temperature condition, and for turbulent flow Nusselt number equal to 0.023, Reynolds number to the power 0.8 and Prandtl number to the power 0.33. So, for the given problem, there are two questions. First question, we have to calculate the Reynolds number for the flow. Second question, the heat transfer per meter length of the duct is in watt, that you have to calculate. So, the heat transfer per meter length of the duct. So, the first question is the Reynolds number. Second question is the heat transfer per meter length of the duct. So, for the first question, the answer is 4.44 10 power 5. Reynolds number is 4.44 10 power 5. And for the second question, heat transfer per meter length, it is 769 watts. So, the calculations are shown in the next slide. So, the given data, duct of rectangular cross section 1 meter by 0.5 meter, fluid temperature 20 degree Celsius, and the velocity is 10 meters per second, thermal conductivity is 0.025 watts per meter Kelvin, viscosity is 18 micropascal second, Prandtl number is 0.73, density is 1.2 for the air. And the hydraulic, it is a rectangular duct, we have to calculate the hydraulic diameter. So, DH equal to 4 AC by P. So, AC is the cross-sectional area, P is the perimeter of the rectangular duct. So, 4 into area is 1 into 0.5, perimeter equal to 2 into 1 plus 0.5 equal to 0.67 meter. Then the Reynolds number we calculate, Reynolds number equal to rho V DH by mu. So, 1.2 into 10 into 0.67 divided by 18 into 10 power minus 6. So, 18 micropascal. So, into 10 power 6. So, 4.46 in 10 power 5. So, Reynolds number equal to 4.46 in 10 power 5 is the answer. Then, the Reynolds number is greater than 2000 for flow, internal flow. So, the flow is turbulent. Now, the Nusselt equation for the turbulent flow we have to take. So, Nusselt number equal to 0.023, Reynolds number to the power 0.8. And Prandtl number to the power 0.33. So, this is given in the problem. So, Nusselt number equal to 0.2023 into 4.46 in 10 power 5 to the power 0.8 into 0.73 to the power 0.33 equals 685.63. Now, the heat transfer coefficient H equal to Nusselt number into K by DH, 685.63 into 0.025 divided by 0.67 equal to 25.58 watts per meter square Kelvin. Now, the heat transfer, so heat transfer Q equal to HA into delta T, so area equal to, for the duct perimeter into length is the area, so into delta T. So, 25.58 into 2 into perimeter, so perimeter is 2 into 1 plus 0.5 into length equal to 1, so delta T is 30 minus 20, which is 767.4, the close answer is 769 watts, that is the answer for the heat transfer. The next question from 2007 question paper, the temperature distribution within the laminar boundary layer over a heated isothermal flat plate is given by T minus TW divided by T infinity minus TW equal to 3 by 2 Y by delta T minus 1 by 2 Y by delta T to the power 3, where TW, T infinity are the temperature of the plate and the free steam respectively, and the Y is the normal distance measured from the plate. The local Nusselt number based on the thermal boundary layer thickness is given by 1.33, 1.5, 2, 4.64. So, we have to calculate the Nusselt number from the given temperature distribution, and the answer is 1.5. So, we will see how in the next slide. So, the temperature distribution is given. T minus T W divided by T infinity minus T W equal to 3 by 2. The temperature profile is given 3 by 2 into Y by delta T minus 1 by 2 into Y by delta T to the power 3. Now you differentiate this equation. So dT by dy. So differentiate it with respect to y. dT by dy equal to T infinity minus TW into 3 by 2 y. Y differentiating y, it is 1 by delta T minus 1 by 2 3 y square by delta T to the power 3. At y equal to 0, substituting y equal to 0 in the equation, dT by dy at y equal to 0 equal to T infinity minus TW into 3 by 2 1 by delta T. Now for the heat transfer, convection heat transfer, heat conducted at the surface of the plate is equal to heat conducted to the fluid. So heat conducted at the surface of the plate equal to minus Ka dT by dy, and heat conducted to the fluid is Ha into TW minus T infinity. So A is getting cancelled. So area is getting cancelled. So minus K into dT by dy at y equal to 0 equal to what we calculate as my T infinity minus TW into 3 by 2 1 by delta. 1 by delta T. So 3 by 2 1 by delta T equal to H into TW minus T infinity. Now the negative sign is dropped, changing the direction, negative sign is dropped. So the delta TW minus T infinity is getting cancelled. So K into 3 by 2 1 by delta T equal to H. So rearranging the term, H into delta T divided by K is Nusselt number with respect to the thermal bond layer thickness. So which is 3 by 2, which is 1.5. So this is the answer to the question. The next question from 2007 question paper. The average heat transfer coefficient on a thin hot vertical plate suspended in still air can be determined from the observations of the change in the plate temperature with the time as it cools. Assume the plate temperature to be uniform at any given instant of time and radiation heat exchange within the surrounding is negligible. The ambient temperature is 25 degrees Celsius. The plate has a total surface area of 0.1 meter square and the mass equal to 4 kg. The specific heat of the plate material is 2.5 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. The convective heat transfer coefficient watts per meter square Kelvin at the instant when the plate temperature is 225 degrees Celsius. And the change in plate temperature with the time dT by dt equal to minus 0.02 Kelvin per second is, we have four options. So we have to calculate the heat transfer coefficient when for the given condition. So the hot plate, it is losing heat energy to the surrounding by means of convection. So the answer here, it is 10. So heat transfer coefficient is 10. We will see how in the next slide. So the given data, T infinity 25 degrees Celsius, area of the plate 0.1 meter square, mass of the plate 4 kilograms, so specific heat of the material, plate material 2.5 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, and the wall temperature is 225 degrees Celsius, temperature gradient dT by dt equal to minus 0.02 Kelvin per second. So the plate loses its heat energy. So the decrease in internal energy of the plate is equal to convection heat transfer. Also, whatever energy decreases in the plate, that is being convected to the surrounding. So the decrease in internal energy of the plate minus mcp into dt by dt. So minus sign for decrease in temperature of the plate, Ha into delta T. So substituting minus 4 into 2500. dT by dt is minus 0.02 into H into 0.1 into delta T. So H equal to 10 watts per meter square Kelvin. So this is the answer to the problem. So match the list 1 and list 2. So list 1, we have the compressible flow, free surface flow, bound layer flow, pipe flow and the heat conduction. And list 2, Reynolds number, Nusselt number, Weber number, Froude number, Mach number and skin friction coefficient. So for compressible flow, Mach number, free surface flow, Weber number, bound layer flow, skin friction coefficient, pipe flow, Reynolds number, heat convection, Nusselt number. So these are all the correct answers. The next question from 2011 question paper. Ratio of laminar bound layer thickness and the thermal bound layer thickness of two fluids P and Q on a flat plate is 1 by 2 and 2 respectively. The Reynolds number based on the plate length for both the flow is 104. The Prandtl number and the Nusselt number for P are 1 by 8 and 35 respectively. the Prandtl number and Nusselt number for Q respectively we have to calculate. So for the given condition, the Prandtl number and the Nusselt number for the Q we have to find out. So there are four options: 8, 140, 870, 470, 435. We will see. The answer is 8, 140. For the fluid Q, Prandtl number is 8, Nusselt number is 140. So we will see how. For fluid P, delta by delta T equal to 1 by 2. Delta is the hydrodynamic boundary layer thickness, delta T is the thermal boundary layer thickness is 1 by 2. For Q, delta by delta T equal to 2. So delta by delta T is Prandtl number to the power 1 by 3 equal to 1 by 2. So here Prandtl number equal to 1 by 2 to the power 3 equal to 1 by 8, which is 0.125. And similarly here Prandtl number to the 1 by 3 equal to 2. So Prandtl number equal to 2 to the power 3 equal to 8. So for both the cases, Reynolds number is 104. Nusselt number is 35. For P, Nusselt number equal to 35. For laminar flow over a flat plate, Nusselt number is proportional to Reynolds number to the power 0.5 and Prandtl number to the power 0.333. Now you find the ratio, Nusselt number for the Q divided by Nusselt number for the P, that is equal to Reynolds number for Q divided by Reynolds number for P to the power 0.5, Prandtl number to the power Q divided by Prandtl number to the power P to the power 0.333. So the Reynolds number for both the fluid is equal to 1. So 1 to the power 0.5. So Reynolds number for Q 8. Sorry, Prandtl number for Q 8 and Prandtl number for P 0.125. So to the power 0.333, that is 4. The answer is 4. So Nusselt number Q for the fluid Q equal to 4 times of Nusselt number for P. So 4 into 35 equal to 140. So for fluid Q, Prandtl number is 8 and Nusselt number is 140. That is the answer to the problem. The next question from 2014 question paper. Consider one-dimensional steady state heat conduction across a wall as shown in the figure of thickness 30 millimeter and thermal conductivity 15 watts per meter Kelvin. At x equal to 0, a constant heat flux 1 into 10 power 5 watts per meter square is applied. On the other side of the wall, the heat is removed from the wall by convection with a fluid 25 degrees Celsius and heat transfer coefficient 250 watts per meter square Kelvin. The temperature of the fluid, temperature at in degree Celsius at x equal to 0 equal to dash. So here we have to find out the temperature. This is the plate of thickness 30 millimeter. So here we apply the heat flux 1 into 10 power 5 watts per meter square and the heat is removed by the fluid with the temperature 25 degrees Celsius and heat transfer coefficient 250 watts per meter square Kelvin. Now the question is, we have to find out the temperature here. So the heat flux equal to T1 minus T infinity divided by the corresponding two resistances. The first resistance for the conduction heat transfer across the wall and the second resistance for the convection resistance for the outside fluid. So we are given 1 into 10 power 5 equal to T1 minus 25 divided by 0.03 divided by 15 plus 1 by 250. So calculating the temperature T1 equal to 625 degree Celsius. So the temperature on the plate T1 equal to 625 degree Celsius. The answer is 625 degree Celsius. Next question from 2014 question paper. The non-dimensional fluid temperature profile near the surface of a convectively cooled flat plate is given by TW minus T divided by TW minus T infinity equal to A plus B into Y by L plus C into Y by L whole square, where Y is measured perpendicular to the plate, L is the length and the ABC are arbitrary constant. TW and T infinity are the wall and the ambient temperature respectively. If the thermal conductivity of the fluid is K and the wall heat flux is Q dash, Q double dash, Nusselt number NU, so Q double dash by TW minus T infinity L by K is equal to, we have four options, A, B, 2C, B plus C. The correct answer is B. We will see how in the next slide. So the temperature distribution is given, TW minus T infinity, TW minus T divided by TW minus T infinity equal to A plus B, Y by L plus C into Y by L whole square. I am changing the direction, T minus TW, T infinity minus TW, right hand side is the same because here negative sign is getting cancelled. Now differentiate this equation. So dt by dy equal to t infinity minus tw into b by l, differentiating this equation. So first b by l is constant, differentiating y equal to 1, c into 2y by l square.
at y equal to 0, substituting y equal to 0, so dt by dy at y equal to 0 equal to t infinity minus tw into b by n. Now the heat conducted at the surface of the plate is equal to heat convected to the fluid. So minus ka dt by dy equal to hca into tw minus t infinity. So a is getting cancelled, minus k into dt by dy equal to t infinity minus tw into b by l equal to h into tw minus t infinity. So kb by l equal to h. So Nusselt number equal to hl by k equal to b. So rearranging Nusselt number equal to hl by k equal to b, that is the answer to the problem. Next question from 2014 question paper. Water flows through a tube of diameter 25 mm at an average velocity of 1 meters per second. The properties of water are mu 7.25 10 power minus 4 Newton second per meter square, density 1000 kilogram per meter cube, thermal conductivity 0.625 watts per meter Kelvin, Prandtl number 4.85. Using Nusselt number equal to 0.023, Reynolds number to the power 0.8 and Prandtl number to the power 0.4. The convective heat transfer coefficient is dash watts per meter square Kelvin. So we have to simply calculate Reynolds number. First we calculate the Reynolds number, rho Vd by mu. So 1000 into 1 into 0.025 divided by 7.25 10 power minus 4. So 34482.75. And using the Nusselt's equation, Nusselt number equal to 0.023. Reynolds number to the power 0.8. Prandtl number to the power 0.4. So Nusselt number equal to for circular tube HD by K 0.023 into 34482.75 to the power 0.8 into 4.85 to the power 0.4. So the Nusselt number equal to 184.54. So heat transfer coefficient is 184.54 into 0.625 divided by 0.025 equal to 4613.5. So the answer is 4613.5 watts per meter square Kelvin. The next question from 2016 question paper, for flow through a pipe of radius r, the velocity and the temperature distribution are as follows. Velocity distribution u r x equal to c1, temperature distribution t r x equal to c2 into 1 minus r by capital R to the power 3, where c1 c2 are the constant. The bulk mean temperature is given by tm equal to 2 by u m r square into integral u r t r at r into dr, where um being the mean velocity of the flow. The value of tm is, we have four options, 0.5 c2 by um, 0.5 c2, 0.6 c2, 0.6 c2 by um. The correct answer is 0.6 c2. We'll see how. So the temperature distribution, we just integrate, substitute the values and integrate. Tm is given as 2 by u rm r square into integral 0 to r u and T R D R. So U velocity distribution is C1 constant, temperature distribution is C2 into 1 minus R by capital R to the power 3 R into D R. The C1 C2 are constant, it is taken out 2 C1 C2 by U M R square integral. So multiplying by R, R into R minus R to the power 4 divided by capital R to the power 3 D R, integrating 2 C1 C2 by U M R square, integrating R, R square by 2, integrating r to the power 4, r to the power 5 divided by 5 capital R to the power 3. So substituting limit 0 to r, tm equal to 2 c1 c2 divided by um r square by 2 minus r to the power 5 divided by 5 r to the power 3. Now taking the denominator, 5 10 r to the power 3, 5 r square minus 2 r square. So other values are constant as it is. Now 2 c1 c2 divided by um r square. So, numerator 3 r square divided by 10 r to the power 3. So, r to the power 5 is getting cancelled. We will get 3 into 2, 6 c1 c2 divided by 10 um. Now, we are given um equal to c1. Um equal to the velocity distribution, mean velocity distribution, which is also c1. So, tm, c1 is getting cancelled. Because um and c1, they are equal. So, tm equal to 6 into c2 divided by 6, c divided by 10. So equal to 0.6 times of C2. So the mean temperature is 0.6 times of C2. That is the answer to the problem. Next question from 2016 question paper. A fluid of Prandtl number 1 at the 500 Kelvin flows over a flat plate 1.5 meter length maintained at 300 Kelvin. velocity of the fluid is 10 meters per second. Assuming kinematic viscosity 30 into 10 power minus 6 meters square per second, the thermal boundary layer thickness at 0.5 meter from the leading edge is dash. So Reynolds number, first we calculate Reynolds number equal to rho Vd by mu, which is also equal to Vd by nu. Nu is the kinematic viscosity, which is mu by rho. So dynamic viscosity divided by the density equal to kinematic viscosity. So 10 into 0.5 divided by 30 into 10 power minus is equal to 1.667 in 10 power 5. Now the flow is laminar. For laminar flow, delta by delta t equal to Prandtl number to the power 0.333. So Prandtl number is given as 1. So 1 to the power 0.333 equal to 1. So delta equal to delta t. So delta equal to 5x by square root of Reynolds number. So 5 into 0.5 divided by Reynolds number is 1.667 to the power 5. So the thermal boundary thickness is 6.12 millimeter. So the answer is 6.12 millimeter. Next question from 2019 question paper. The wall of a constant diameter pipe of length 1 meter is heated uniformly with a heat flux Q dash by warping a heater coil around it. The flow at the inlet to the pipe is hydrodynamically fully developed. The fluid is incompressible and the flow is assumed to be laminar and steady all through the pipe. The bulk temperature of the fluid is equal to 0 degree Celsius at the inlet, 50 degree Celsius at the exit. The wall temperature are measured in three locations, P, Q, R, as shown in the figure. So 50 degree, 80 degree and 90 degree respectively. So P, 50 degree, Q, 80 degree, R, 90 degree respectively. The flow is thermally developed after some distance from the inlet. Among the locations P, Q, R of the flow, P, Q, R, the flow is fully developed at P, Q, R, P and Q only, R only, Q and R only. So the for the given flow conditions, the fully developed flow is achieved. Which point? Either P, Q, R or Q, R or P, Q or only R. So the correct answer is Q and R. So we will see how in the next slide. And this is the pipe. So here total length of the pipe is 1 meter. So from this is the point number 1 and this is point number 5. So point number 2, 3, 4, 5. So 2 is P, 3 is Q and 4 is R. 5 is the outlet. P the temperature is 50 degree Celsius, Q the temperature is 80 degree Celsius, R the temperature is 90 degree Celsius. Now for energy balance between 1 and 5. So Q into pi dL. So heat transfer into pi dL. Heat transfer, heat flux, heat transfer equal to mCp into T5 minus T1. So Q into pi d, length, total length is 1 meter. Pi d into 1, mCp into 50. Here the temperature is 50, here the temperature is 0. 50 minus 0 is 50. So Q pi d divided by mCp equal to 50. This is what the conclusion from the first energy balance. Now the energy balance between 1 and 2. So 1 is here, 2 is point P. So pi dL into L equal to mCp into T2 minus T1. So pi d into L equal to 0.4, 0.2 plus 0.2, 2 equal to 0.4 equal to mCp into T2 minus 0, T1 equal to 0. So rearranging T2 equal to Q pi d into 0.4 divided by mCp. We have Q pi d by mCp equal to 50. So 50 into 0.4 equal to 20 degree Celsius. So T2 equal to 20 degree Celsius. So here the temperature is 20 degree Celsius. Next is the energy balance between 1 and 3. So Q pi dL equal to mCp into T3 minus T1. So Q pi dL between 1 and 3 is 0.6 meter. So this is the 0.3. So 0.6 is mCp into T3 minus 0. So T3 equal to Q pi d into 0.6 divided by mCp. So this equal to 50 into 0.6 equal to 30 degree Celsius. Then the energy balance between 0.1 and 4. So 1 and 4 is R. So pi d and Q pi dL equal to mCp T4 minus T1. So Q pi d into up to 4, the length is 0.8 equal to mCp into T4 minus 0. So T4 equal to Q pi d into 0.8 divided by mCp, which is 50 into 0.8 equal to 40 degree Celsius. Now for steady fully developed flow, delta T is constant. Delta Tp at the point P, the delta delta T is Tp minus T2, which is 50 minus 20 equal to 30 degrees Celsius. For delta Tq, so Tq minus T3 equal to 80 minus 30, 50 degrees Celsius. Delta Tr, Tr minus T4 equal to 90 minus 40 equal to 50 degrees Celsius. So, the temperature for fully developed flow, the flow should be steady flow, steady fully developed flow, delta T is constant. So, delta T is constant between the point Q and R. So, at the point Q, the delta T is 50 degrees Celsius. At point R, the delta T is 50 degrees Celsius. The temperature difference is constant from point Q to point R. So, the flow is fully developed only between the point Q and R. That is the answer to the question. So, we stop here. So, these are all the books I publish in the mechanical engineering subject. And I have a YouTube channel where I upload the video lectures on the subject and the solution to the gate question paper. You subscribe the channel, use the videos for your better preparation and passing the gate examination. And thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can raise your doubt in my mail ID or WhatsApp number. I will sincerely answer to your queries. We'll meet again in another video with the solution to the heat transfer questions.